Is it possible to improve our processing speed? Yes, definitely. Like with any other cognitive ability, we can train, learn, and improve processing speed. The key to improving processing speed is based on making more solid connections in the brain, which allows the signals to travel faster to one another. Although we create the majority of these types of connections in childhood, with some practice and training, you can maintain and even improve your brain's processing speed. How? Well, thanks to brain plasticity, the brain is able to change its structure and function. Brain plasticity allows us to create new brain connections and increase the amount of neural circuits. This improves functionality. If neuroscience and studying brain plasticity has shown us anything, it is that the more neural circuits we use, the stronger they will become, which is applicable to processing speed. So here I give you 7 ways to improve your processing speed. 1. Live a healthy lifestyle. Living a healthy lifestyle improves your brain's processing speed. Firstly, try implementing a quick exercise program at home before you begin studying or taking a test. Walk briskly, bike, jog, do jumping jacks, or crank out some push-ups. By getting your blood flowing, you prepare your body for improved cognitive function. Secondly, along with the right amount of exercise, you should also maintain a balanced diet. You can additionally focus on specific foods linked to brain health, such as avocados, blueberries, and wild salmon. Finally, get about 7 to 8 hours of sleep every night. The brain forms new pathways while you sleep, and getting the right amount of sleep helps to improve your processing speed. 2. Keep learning. The brain continues making new connections, so learning a task builds new connections, and mastering those tasks strengthens the connections in a way that makes the information travel across axons more quickly. 3. Break up your attention periods. Whatever you're focusing on, the most efficient way to focus on something is doing it in short bursts. If you try to focus on something for an extended period, your focus and intensity will falter. Instead, you're better off giving it 100% for a shorter period, then you take a break and return again when you're ready to focus. So set a timer and challenge yourself to stay focused for 20 minutes at a time. Reward yourself with breaks in between sessions so that you're always approaching your work with a fresh mind. 4. Make minor, unimportant decisions fast. For example, the next time you go out to eat, challenge yourself to choose your meal in a minute or less. Don't worry if you don't choose wisely, since the consequences are small. When you really want to make a decision fast, flip a coin. You may find yourself inwardly hoping for one outcome over another, which will help you know what you really want. I wouldn't recommend you doing this when you make important life-changing decisions, though. 5. Practice doing things you're good at faster. If you play music, learn to play songs with a faster tempo. If you do puzzles or play games like chess, set a timer to force yourself to work faster. Finally, you can set a timer to see how fast you can do a simple chore like cleaning your desk or preparing a meal. Don't try this with something you're just learning, though, as you'll only get frustrated. 6. Stop trying to multitask. I said stop crying because, in fact, you don't actually multitask because your brain can't focus on two tasks at once and instead quickly toggles back and forth between tasks. It's well documented that trying to multitask can reduce your attention span, which is essential for processing information. So get in the habit of giving one task at a time your undivided attention. 7. Be socially active. Although communicating via social media or on your electronic devices is fun, it also gives you time to ruminate over conversations. When you engage with others face to face rather than digitally, however, it forces you to process info quickly and give a fast response. This information came from these websites. You will find these links below this video. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. Next Friday, I'll be back with a new episode in my IQ series. Till then, I only want to say three things. Thank you for watching, have a great day, and bye y'all.